Are you ready for San Francisco Shock versus the Vancouver Titans?
You know what? I just got to have a time machine from 2019. I am ready. Let's get this rematch on the road.
That's right. Yeah. Maybe a chance there, but I don't think that's really going to follow through. Yeah, they finally forced their way on. San Francisco playing this one a little bit on the safer side. And oh, maybe I spoke too soon. A striker goes down, gets Mario stomped by Chongsik. And possibly Vancouver might be able to get some percent going early. Yeah, looks like they will.
Yeah, I mean, Chuck's being smart about this. Chuck didn't stay around and go, oh, let's try and fight this 5v6. It's not something you can really do in this meta without a huge amount of ults on hand. Chuck just go, all right, we're going to back out, and Vancouver doesn't chase it down. And the upside, the Chuck get to go right back in. Moira, yep, opening up with the Cole, narrow, immediately off the duplicate. Double D.Va on the field, FD God, or at the beat. It's an ult advantage for Chuck to kick things off with fire. Builds up beat mid-fight. Vancouver starting to bring it back. Narrow, though, catches Roof on the self-destruct. That's massive. The healing for Vancouver, it's not going to be there, Doa. And the Shock can just slowly clean this up.
Could be, yeah, without the tank. Striker doesn't get anyone, but FT God, meanwhile, picking up a bloodthirsty support kill anyway. Dalton, just get one over onto Violet. Maybe the self-destruct grab something? No, not quite.
Went back.
San Francisco either way. Recapturing, having no problems at all with that. And can they win the fight, though? Oh, Vancouver. All right, yep, coming back. This isn't over yet, CB.
They were able to swap it back over, and now for the Shock, they actually don't have that much time to bring it back. 15% left to go. This is where, similar to how Fried had to sort of take himself out of the fight to the beginning, someone from the Shock's going to have to do that as this kicks off. And now,
yeah,
93%, who's it going to be?
Well, we'll see. Vancouver Titans in a position to put a point on the board. San Francisco comes in with the sound barrier. They drop it. Vancouver, fire.
Oh, no, fire!
Fire! He gets booped off by Smurf before he gets to use the ultimate. That is devastating for Vancouver. Oh, not like this, ZP. Not like this.
He dropped
this,
the beat down on the street, Doa, but not where it needed to be. Oh, absolute disaster.
You'd think someone named Smurf would like blue people, but no, that's not the case, as the blue team Vancouver is basically all sent off the edge. And that is a pretty rough ending to that map. Oh, man. But Zeke, maybe a couple shots from Nero. Yeah, just looking for somebody in the window, and he's not going to find it. So back over to Echo. So it will be the comp we know from San Francisco. Vancouver, though, swapping things up a little bit. Has different tanks. You've got the McCree in there and Rolf on the Batiste as well. See what they can do with it.
As we were talking about during the break, this puts so much pressure on your McCree, in this case, Dalton.
Right.
Dalton is the storyline here. Can Dalton do enough damage to the Shock before the sustain of the composition of the Shock is running just runs over Vancouver? And there is a timeline to this. It needs to happen sooner rather than later, because you look at the Shock, Doa, they're just going to bully on in, already onto the point.
Why not?
Already starting to push the Shock out, or already starting to push the Titans out, and it's a real problem for the Titans as Dalton, under pressure, nearly goes down.
Oh. Nero, though, overstaying his welcome on the point, and now Vancouver's starting to turn this one around. Dalton, you talked about the pressure being on him, but he's delivering. D-Mex, Choyobin, and it looks like San Francisco will have to go back to the drawing board for now. So, honestly, they've got this high ground here. We'll see how aggressive San Francisco wants to be, but they have certainly been the aggro team so far in this matchup.
Yeah, and I mean, that's what you want to do when you're playing this composition. You win off sustain, you win by taking the fight to the other team. Vancouver, of course, swap things up just a bit. The fight taking place.
Pretty good grab.
On top. Flux on the way down. Shotgun low. Striker out of the fight immediately.
All right.
And that's going to be enough.
It will be. And they use everything except for the drums. So they've still got that Orisa ultimate at least. You know, had to end up using both defensive ultimates, the window and the rally. But overall, they prevented Shock from getting anything. So that's probably arguably the best defense they've had on this map so far.
Yeah. And also, just as a side, look at Pride. I feel like his mustache just gets more majestic every time. Really growing that one out.
That's right. Soon it'll turn into two prehensile appendages, and it'll be able to press extra keys on his keyboard. I can't wait for that.
That's a competitive advantage. I'm all here for it. But the Shock, Doa, they're heading in. Early Cole being used. Striker again. Just takes a rock to the grill. Immediately denied. And yeah, Cole's not going to be enough for that one, Doa, as Vancouver rejects the Shock up on top.
Yep. They're coming in. Die, die, die.
From all sides, it's a lot of spinning, but no one going down just yet. Smurf, though, again, awfully low. Doa has to jump up. A little bit of a reprieve. Still alive somehow. And Smurf is chased down. Dalton's able to find him. And Vancouver continues to hold on. Only a minute 20 left, Doa. And this could be a great start for Vancouver trying to take the map.
He's going to try to come up the stairs again. Here we go.
Fried opened up with another rock. This time, Striker still lives to tell the tale. Smurf, Primal Rage, gets rid of the supercharger early. This shock nearly through. They have to invest a lot more, and Choi's going to get demeked. Choi wasn't able to get self-destruct up in time. And Vancouver, they're a little bit beaten right now, though, but they're healed all the way back up. Striker goes down again, and Vancouver just about have done it. Only 20 seconds left. The shock really don't have enough time for another full good attack.
Yeah. You know, Nero gets one down to Teru, but, you know, there's such fast respawns of the defense on Hanamura that that's going to be mitigated really fast. Changshik over to the ball just to make sure he's able to get back to the defense as well. But, yeah, 5 seconds. I don't know. Can San Francisco even get back there in time? Okay, they do. They get Smurf there with the ball. But can they possibly cap this? It's going to be chaotic.
Yeah, this is the chaos fight where you throw everyone on the point at different times, hope it works out. Vancouver, they just have to remain poised. Already have the duplicated D.Va on the field. Dalton goes for the Death Blossom, and that's a finisher, Doa. Takes down Striker and FD God, and your pickup's about to lose a point. If you predded 3-0 Shock, well, maybe not just yet. There's still the attack, so we're going to hold on, but it's not looking good.
That's it. Wow. Vancouver Titans with a pretty awesome defense, I gotta say, on Hanamura. San Francisco Shock just kind of, you know, butting their heads into the wall over and over again on that one. You know, I don't know if it was maybe the cleanest attacks we ever seen from San Francisco, but credit to the Titans. You know, they played it out efficiently. They had a good plan. They responded well to things like Striker trying to put some flanks into the mix. And yeah, I gotta say, nicely done by the Titans.
Yep. And this is where both teams right now, you made a really good point, though, about alt economy being a big deal. Both teams right now, it's all the charge coal. It's all, we're going to take some damage, we're going to heal some damage up. And between the two teams right now, the Shock are winning that fight. Violet, 75% to Rulf at 65. And this is where as soon as the Shock get coal, they're going to go. And Vancouver, they want to commit now. They want to take the fight to the Shock. But the coal is coming, even as Vancouver head over to the point.
Yeah, just dodge it, though. I mean, you can step back behind the wall. Oh, but they lose Teru. So Titans fighting that 5v6. Make it a 4v6. As Striker grabs two, comes in on the flank with that Reaper. Looks like the defense might do okay for the Shock this time, ZV.
Yep, and again, just slight advantage in ult economy do mean quite a bit here. Bible was able to get the coal out a little bit earlier. And even with Vancouver heading to the point, you know, the advantage of that slightly earlier coal cannot be understated. And now you go to the next fight. The Shock in a much better situation for ult economy here early on, especially because Smurf can just open up with a Primal.
Yeah, we'll see what Vancouver can make happen. It looks like there's going to be a lot of ultimates available across the board, depending on how fast Vancouver wants to come in, and they probably should approach it a little bit slower. They're so close to having a pretty good attack, but no, they're going aggressive. Wow, Terror onto the D.Va immediately.
Moving in. Beat out early from the Shock. Uh-oh. Vancouver super low, but a well-timed beat from Fire. Woo. Now Chomsek uses the Primal. They push the other way. Teru in on the duplicated D.Va. It's double D.Va versus double Winston. Primal's out here for the Shock. It's a lot bouncing around, but the bombs are about to start coming as Vancouver pushes in. Fried still holding onto his Smurf. Primal's down, under pressure, 300 HP. Death Blossom from Dalton off on the other side. Vancouver, they're muscling their way in here, Daw, but Chongsek is super low, so low right now. You look at his health, he's under pressure, trying to stay alive. He gets healed back up, Dalton punishes Smurf, and Vancouver about to take the point.
That shield cooldown for Chongsek came back at just the right time there. And now with the tanks out of commission for San Francisco, Vancouver looks like they're on track to take point A. And it didn't take him that long, honestly. Pretty good amount of time in the time bank. Oh, but one last contest.
Hang on, it's not over yet.
Eat a few more. Yep, Striker. Nothing out of that one. Violet, there's
the
a
shock,
beat. They're committing to this.
Yeah, they're committing. If they get one more elimination, it might be all they need. Yeah, Vancouver has attacker's advantage.
Wow.
But it's going away as Striker finds his rhythm. 98.4%. A little bit of decision paralysis. Do I go for the echo? Do I go for the ground? Goes back to ground. Beat invested by Fire. There is a significant beat advantage here for Vancouver because Shock had to use it to come back into the fight, but the beat's about faded here. Vancouver didn't get any eliminations. Narrow, under pressure, builds up the self-destruct just in time. Gonna make a little bit more space. Chongsik now, Primal Rage, good to go. Vancouver, final gasp here, 30 seconds left. They want to get point A, Doa. Point B, they don't have to go far, but they're struggling to get an elimination. Smurf on a whim, so low, Doa. Look at Smurf in the back, and he's still somehow alive.
HP. Nero gets one on Terra. Oh my gosh, San Francisco turning it around. FD God was able to build the beat once more, and here comes Striker, and here comes San Francisco, and there go the Titans' hopes at tying up this series. They're not even going to get back to the point again. I think maybe Chongsik can make it, but another heartbreaker ending here. Rolf touches on the Moira.
It.
They force the overtime. Oh boy, ZV.
They're looking for it. This is, again, the Women of Prayer. Chongsik, no HP, spinning around. How long can that last? Well, gets another heal. Vancouver trying to make something out of nothing right now. Self-destructing tarot. Can it hit anything? No, not quite. Choi, though, under pressure. About to get demeched. He's out of there. Vancouver's still at a full six, even with Choxic and Fried. Very, very low right now. Hanging in there. Fried, though, going to get demeched. Both teams going back and forth. Vancouver's fully recovered at this point, Daw. And you look towards the alt. The beat comes in fire.
Second one?
Keeps everyone alive. Vancouver, could they possibly stay alive here, Daw? It's closer than it should be. And Smurf goes down. There won't be a primal.
Oh, Striker. Striker comes in at the end, and there's another beat from FD God. That's going to seal the deal. Oh, it was so close. That's two maps in a row now.
Choi, under pressure. Choi super low, gets taken down. It was Fried and Orisa, a rock and a halt, finishing him off to the side. And Vancouver off that tank pick, that gives him all the room they need to just push out Doa.
You never want to be between a rock and a halt place, that's for sure. Teru, meanwhile, I'm sorry. I'm here all weekend, everyone. Teru, meanwhile, up above, and they do get a little bit of a defensive position on this card as it pushes back. And as the attacker, you've got some corners to kind of maneuver around to get back to the payload. But, you know, now the defense is out of those narrow doors, right? So if Vancouver can hold this, they can pull some more time out of the time bank for Shock.
I mean, they've already pulled a lot out. I mean, think about it. Shock had a really good point of attack 5 minutes ago. Now it's down to 2.5. You know, it's not bad at all for Vancouver, given where they started from. Fried going for the flux. What's it going to get? Narrow. Off the duplicate. Oh, Glister got two in the back. It doesn't really matter what the flux is doing at this point. Glister landing every shot he needs. Narrow drops a flux of his own, and that should be point B here, though. Lenting. Glister, though, gets caught by Teru. Fire getting the res on the Fried. This is still winnable now for Vancouver as Dalton picks off Narrow on the other end. And the Shock were really far ahead, but you can't go that far deep, though. You still got to respect who's still up.
Yeah. I mean, Teru, I think, with a nice heads-up play on the Echo, copying the Orisa to get their own damage boost for the defense, and that was a big part of being able to push what was left of the San Francisco Shock team back.
Yeah, I also like how Echoes have just leveled up over time, where the quality of Echo primals have increased dramatically. No! A nice twofer from Dalton. That was sick. Finds FD God, and that's the one person you can't res, Noah.
Today, yeah.
There is a silver line. It's a small silver lining, but it's still there. The Shock, they did invest both Supercharger and Duplicate Vancouver. They were able to save their flux at the very least. So there's still a chance, but it's rapidly decreasing as time goes on.
I mean, it's not really even about point A at this point. You know, I mean, Titans can take point A, and they're just going to have so much less time in the time bank overall that taking that point C, that really difficult to take point for the attackers, is really a trick. Look at this. From the Shock hiding on the flank.
Yeah,
that's a bit silly, but it works.
It gets worse, Doa. He also used the flux. Yeah. So even if Vancouver did recover in 15 seconds, which actually is not super likely, they don't have the flux to go with it. So this one, just about done. This is where the Stall Brigade comes out. That's right. Summon your hamsters, summon your monkeys, and die on the point gracefully.
That's just... It's rough to see. Vancouver Titans only able to get the Dragon ult. The Dragon Strike makes it the point, but that don't count CP. And it's going to be... a 3-0 victory for the San Francisco Shock.